What's going on, guys? PXCam20 back in with a brand new video. We are here at my home track of WeatherTech Laguna Seca as we are doing our nation's FIA race here at WeatherTech Laguna Seca. We are ranked 6th place on this lobby as we had already done a lobby earlier and we did all right. We were able to start in 12th and finish in 6th place. So I wanted to do another one and see if we can get a better finish on this race as I felt really, really confident with this car. So if you guys don't know, we are only using the Porsche Cayman or the Chevy Corvette, but you can see right here the majority of the people decided to go with the Cayman, as that car, for me at least, I don't know about other people, but this was the best car to run around WeatherTech Laguna Seca. It just has so much grip, was very easy to drive, and just tire wise was the best with the tire compared to the Chevy Corvette. So now as we jump into the points, the most that we can get was 225 points if we get first place here. But all we needed to do was get a fourth or better to improve our points rating on our standings for the FIA Cup, as we did get, I believe, 186 points on the race previous. So before we go into the race, if you guys really enjoy the content, please subscribe to the channel and leave a like on the video. It really helps out the channel when you guys do so. Anyways, that's enough promoting myself. Let's jump straight into qualifying. Now, as we jump into qualifying, it was very, very important to get into the slipstream, as you can gain almost more than half a second on your lap time if you're able to get into the slipstream. As you can see right here, we were unable to do so, and we were actually able just to get a 127.88 on one of our flyer laps. So we decided to go back out again and try to do another one as we were following this guy, but unfortunately the guy ahead of us did mess us up a little bit on one of the corners, and we were unable to improve our lap time. So we were able to get a qualifying spot of 6th place as we now jump into the intro. So jumping into the intro, the race strategy was to just run the hards and do a no stop, as you were given the mediums and the hard compound tires, but the hards were the mandatory tires that you had to use on this race. So luckily the fuel wasn't that bad of a situation. I mean, if you ran it really, really hard, maybe you can run out of fuel, but it was enough fuel and not enough fuel consumption to allow us to just do a no stop. So we decided to just do the hards, as it does take a very, very long time to go into the pits here at Laguna Seca. So that was gonna be the strategy here. Let's see what we can do now from 6th place as we're gonna jump into the race. As we now jump into the race, we get our 3-2-1 and we are a go. As you can see, the American flag patriotically being waved ahead of us as we are coming down to the first corner now on the front straightaway. So following the pink Canadian right ahead of us, we are just gonna break right before the 3 board, and we are able to get into the first and second corner without any incidents and just follow the Porsches right ahead of us. So the Canadian gets a little bit loose coming out of the second corner, but he's able to hold it together, as that kind of scared me there. I just was trying to build a gap between us and 5th place so we can avoid making any type of contact with them as we now head into the corkscrew for the first time. So coming to the corkscrew for the first time, we take a lot of curbing there as we were very close to getting a penalty, as you can easily get a penalty just like 3rd place did by just cutting the chicane there. And it's just something that you have to be very, very crucial on if you guys are running this racetrack. As you can see, he actually spins out right there and he goes all the way to the dirt. Let's see what happened here. He just clips the left-hand side, hits the dirt, spins out, and goes straight into the wall. And that is a free position for us, as we have another car ahead of us that has a half a second penalty. Not sure exactly what he did. Maybe he ran off track, or he cut a chicane or cut a corner. But for some reason now he's got a half a second penalty. So hopefully we can get close enough to him and maybe get another free position now as we are in 5th place coming to the second lap. So coming to the first corner again, staying right behind the pink Canadian. We're just following him here, just biding our time, as we don't want to do anything too drastic, as it's still very early in the race, as it is still lap 2 of 15. So we just don't want to be pushing any type of issue, accidentally clip some of the dirt and end up spinning ourselves, as the dirt is very, very slippery. You get one tire on that dirt and it's just going to pull you around like it did to the car the lap previous. So coming to the penalty zone here, 2nd place does not lose a lot of time, as he did have to serve his half a second penalty, but you can see it barely affected him there, as we just followed the cars right ahead of us in this train and just follow them in the slipstream, just holding our tires, trying to save them as we are now coming to the hairpin on lap number 2. So jumping to the hairpin, we were actually getting really good traction here, as you can see how much time we were able to make on the Canadian. And that was kind of our strength on this racetrack, as we were getting a really good run now. Coming to the inside, the Canadian holds his line, and we accidentally made contact with the walls. That's going to affect us a little bit as we come into turn number one. And you can see that we lost a lot of time in the Canadian, but he goes a little bit wide now as we're trying to make a move onto the inside. Take a little peek there as we're coming out of turn number two, as we're going to go onto the outside of turn number three. But he's able to get a great run coming out of turn number two, and he's able to hold his position there as we're just going to follow along him and just try to see if we can fight for another lap and stay right behind him and position ourselves again for the next one. So coming out of this corner, you can see we're staying right behind him here as he was able to get a really good exit there. But now we are starting to get really, really close as we come out of the corkscrew and stay right behind him now as we come into the right-hander. So coming to our strongest part of the track, which is the hairpin, we're breaking right after that three board, and you can see how much time we're gaining on him as we clip our apex. He misses his apex a little bit and goes wide as he comes out of the corner, and we are in his slipstream now as we're getting a really good run, trying to move on to the outside. He's going to cover the inside here as we just switch it right here from the outside, go cutting all the way to the inside, and he goes wide, and we're going to go into the inside here, try to make the overtake. Go side by side as we head into turn number one, into turn number two, and we're going a little bit side by side, but we're able to make the pass. And let's see exactly how we got that overtake done, as I was very, very proud of myself there, just to make sell a dummy right there, go very wide, go onto the inside, and is able to get that position done and promote ourselves into fourth place, as we are now trying to try to pull away from him and try to catch up to third and try to get a podium here. So coming out of this corner here, we're sitting on sights on third and second and first, as we actually get a purple sector there. And we're just going to see if we can try to close up this gap here, as you can see how far away we are. But coming into the hairpin on lap number five, you can see how much we're actually closing the gap. I mean, it's not much, but it's getting there, as we were able to close it up by at least half a second there within two laps. So we're just going to keep pushing and pushing, as you can see now on lap number six how much we're able to close the gap even more. And we are now almost in their slipstream. So once we get into the slipstream, it should be a little bit more easier to get to them, as we are only 3.2 seconds away from them, as we are now jumping up a little bit more forward into lap number seven. So coming to lap number seven, the leader actually has a penalty, so that's going to help us out there, as he should be able to hold off some of the cars. And when he has to serve his penalty, who knows if that's going to hold off third place, as we are coming to the first corner. Coming to the first corner, we're able to really, really close the gap here on third place, as we are now almost less than 2 seconds away from him and almost in slipstream range, so we can easily get closer to him now, as first and second are starting to fight with each other. And that's really, really good for us, as they are now going to slow each other down, as second place with the penalty has to serve it here coming to the penalty zone. We're running purple for the first sector again, as that's just been a really, really good sector for us. But you can see right here that second place served his penalty and actually held up third place. So we are getting a really good run now coming out of that corner. And you can see how much time we're gaining on him, as we are now in slipstream range as we come out of this left-hander and onto the straightaway leading us into the corkscrew. So coming out to the straightaway here, we almost basically close the gap by a whole entire second, and we're able to just get really, really close to him as we go a little bit loose coming into the corkscrew, as we almost ran to the back of third place, but luckily we didn't, as we're going to hold it off right here, go into the left hander and to try to stay behind third place and see if we can set him up for an overtake now. So coming to the right hander here, right behind the third place driver, as we are almost going a little bit wide there, we're staying right behind him there as we're going to break right at the three board and try to see if we can get a good exit coming out of this hairpin. And you can see we're able to do so here, as we are now on the back of the third place car as we're knocking on the door for the podium, trying to shift it onto the inside and see if we could sell him a dummy like we did to the other car. But unfortunately, we're just too far back as we're trying to make a move onto the inside, try to break as late as we can. But we are just way too far back to try to make an overtake, as third place shuts the door on us, and he has the right to do so there, as we were not going to try to make a move there. We're just way too far back. So we're just going to keep following him second and first and try to just patiently try to make our way to the podium here as we're heading to the right-hander. So jumping to the right-hander here, the third place car was able to pull away just a tad bit, but we were able to get back to him as we were in the slipstream. So that's been helping us out. We're staying close to him now as we're coming into lap number 10. Coming to lap number 10, we actually lost a little bit of time to third place. You can see it's a bigger gap from the lap previous. And we're just going to try to see if we can stay behind the slipstream and try to just get closer to him now, as we're actually getting a little bit close to first place. The second place gets a little bit loose coming out of that fast left-hander. And you can see how much time we're actually gaining on third as we head now into the corkscrew. So coming to the corkscrew here, we're shifting our brake bias to zero, as I was using one brake bias to the rear, but when I came to really hard braking zones, for some reason the back end just wanted to step out, so we had to switch it to the zero brake bias to allow ourselves to not spin out when we get to the heartbreaking zones. We're not coming to the hairpin. So coming to the hairpin here, we break as late as we can, but we accidentally clip the dirt. We make contact with third place, and he actually goes out wide as we accidentally ram into him, and we lose so much time to second and first place as me and third place were accidentally taken out there as I just clipped the dirt there, lost traction, accidentally hit third place. And that was the end result right there as we went straight into the wall. I felt so sorry for the third place driver as it was nothing that he can do. It wasn't his fault. We just braked. We braked late, but we could have made the corner. It was just we clipped the dirt right there and it accidentally punted us into, well, not punted us, but spanned us out into third place. And we punted third place ahead. And now we lost fourth place to Luis Rosen. So we're going to have to do everything we can to try to catch up to Luis and the third place driver and see if we can try to get around them again as we only have 5 laps left, as that was a costly mistake from us. Something that's, like I said, I really did not mean to do that to third place. And luckily after the race, he was understandable and he knew that it was a mistake on my part. But coming into lap number 12 here, going to the first corner, Luis tries to make a move onto the outside of the blue Porsche right here. And you can see he's holding off onto the outside to make a little bit of contact, but he's able to hold it there as he's gonna have the inside coming to turn number 3. He's able to make the overtake there. So now we have to set our sights on the blue Porsche and try to catch up to the gray one ahead of him and see if we can try to get a podium still, as we are following him now onto the right-hander here and trying to catch up to them as we're in the slipstream now coming into lap number 12. So coming into lap number 13 here, staying right behind the blue Porsche right ahead of us, we're moving on to the inside. He's going to hold off the inside. We're going to try to make the move on the outside like the third place driver did to the blue Porsche the lap prior, and we're on the outside here as we're just holding it there, but unfortunately we were unable to do so as fourth place was able to hold this position there. And we're going to try to see if we can get close enough again to try to make a move on the either the inside or the outside of one of these corners again as we're now heading to the hairpin. So having flashbacks here as we head into the hairpin, we try to avoid clipping that dirt and spinning out into the blue Porsche there as we were very, very close to him again. But we get a really great run coming out of the hairpin as we're back in the slipstream now as we're heading on to lap number 14. So only 2 laps left to try to make the move done and try to catch up to third so we can get that podium. As we're trying to make a move onto the outside, try to break as late as we can. We're able to do so. We're trying to pinch him down, but we accidentally outbreak ourselves, go a little too far out coming out of turn number 1 into turn number 2. And he's able to hold off his position now as he clips the dirt. And he actually slows down a little bit there because of the dirt. So getting a little bit loose coming out of that right-hander. We accidentally make contact with the back of him. And we go a little bit wide and so does he. So it's getting a little bit crazy here as we're both getting very, very just crazy with our moves and not keeping it onto the line. But we're just trying to stay right behind him now as we head into this left-hander. Coming to the left-hander, we break as late as we can as we are able to kind of close the gap now as we're staying right behind him on the slipstream. And heading to his fast left-hander, this is where we've been really, really strong at also. As you can see right here, we break as late as we can after that two board, and we get a great exit right there as we are now running up onto the corkscrew here, going onto the inside of the blue Porsche as we're moving onto the inside, break as late as we can. But the blue Porsche actually outbreaks himself, goes very, very wide as we're trying to keep it onto the inside, and we're able to make the overtake now on the blue Porsche as we go into the replay. You can see that we were just on the inside there, and I think he was just too focused on us, missed his breaking point, goes very, very wide. Luckily he was able to keep it onto the track, and luckily he didn't make contact with us when he did keep it onto the track. And we get an easy fourth place right there as we are now setting our sights on the podium as we come into the final lap. So on the final lap here, as we're heading to the straightaway leading us into our strong left-hander here, breaking right after the two board, you can see that second place gets very, very loose and he is now on the inside there. So that can be an easy podium for us if we're able to catch up to him now as we're heading to the corkscrew. Coming to the corkscrew, we're breaking right after that three board, and we're able to hit the corkscrew really, really well. As you can see, we're getting a really good run coming out of that corner, but third place is still getting very, very squirrely. So we're just trying to do everything we can to push our car to try to get as close as we can to the third place car and try to make a move onto the podium before the hairpin. Coming to the right-hander here, we are able to close the gap as we are almost on his back bumper. He gets onto the dirt again, gets very, very loose. He's trying to defend the inside as we go onto the outside, going side by side into the hairpin. Are we able to get it as we get a little bit of contact there? Shift into third gear, accidentally shift into fourth gear, and that loses our momentum as we are going to lose the podium because of a costly mistake. And we finished this race in fourth place after making a horrible mistake. You see right here that we shifted into fourth gear way too soon, and we were unable to get our podium here as we probably could have if we would have dragged race to the line. Who knows, anything could have happened right there. But we just made a really dumb mistake right there as we accidentally double shift. I've never done that in my life. And this was the result, as we lost out on a podium chance and we were only able to finish in fourth place we were able to make up two positions from our starting grid and get 197 points towards our FIA Nations Cup standing. So very, very sad there, as I just wanted to get a podium on this race, or if not, try to get a win. But we were right there for a podium as we went, you know, to the outside of the hairpin, and we got a really good run coming out as we made a little bit of contact with the third place car, but we just made a costly mistake and double shift again, something I've never done ever in my life, but I guess the pressure got to me and I accidentally double shift, and this was the result. But other than that, it was a really good race as we had a lot of good overtakes and really good entertaining fun, except for the mistake that we did on the third place car. So a couple of mistakes that we made here that could have easily costed us the win, or if not, at least the podium. So hopefully we can bounce back here and get a good result on the next FIA race, as it's going to be this Saturday. So if you guys really enjoyed that video, please subscribe to the channel and leave a like on the videos. It really helps out the channel when you guys do so. And if you guys want to support the channel, I have left my Patreon in the link down in the description down below. And if you guys found this video very entertaining, I hope to see you guys on the next one. Peace out.